Once the Mars Perseverance rover arrives at Mars, the next challenge facing it is landing on the Martian surface. A whole new landing system was developed for Curiosity, and now Perseverance uses the same landing method. After entering Mars' atmosphere, the supersonic parachute is deployed, and the heat shield is discarded. The craft slows to about 200 miles per hour, still too fast to land. What's left is the descent vehicle cradling the rover, both still tucked inside the back shell. Pyrotechnic or explosive bolts fire and disconnect the descent stage and rover from the back shield. Within seconds, onboard software fires up the descent stage's 8 retro rockets. The descent stage deliberately turns to the side so that it stays clear of the back shell and parachute. With the rover still attached, the descent stage with its retro rockets firing begins to lower the rover toward the ground. Each of the engines uses a hydrazine propellant. 8 engines are used during the initial portion of the descent before 4 of them enter a near shutdown level so they can function as backups. The descent stage cannot ride all the way down to the ground with a rover because the blast from its jets would blow up so much dust, rocks, and debris that it would harm the rover and its electronics and instruments. It would also be very unstable. That's why the sky crane maneuver was developed. And here's where the sky crane maneuver starts. When the descent stage receives notice that it is as close to the ground as it is allowed to get, it is time to completely disconnect itself from the rover. The rover and the descent stage are connected to each other with rigid connections paired with pyrotechnic or explosive bolts. The bolts blow and sever the rigid connections between the rover and the descent stage. The rover is now free of the rigid connections to the descent stage, but it is still connected to the descent stage by 3 nylon Vectran bridle ropes. Once free of the rigid connections, the rover drops under its own weight, connected only by the 3 ropes connected to the bridle spool located on the descent stage. There is only 1 bridle spool and all 3 ropes are wound around it. If you look carefully, you can see all 3 ropes wound around the spool. The bridle device assembly measures about 2 feet from top to bottom and has 2 main parts. The cylinder on the top is the descent brake, and the conical device below it is the spool that holds the rope. The 3 ropes unspool from the bridle assembly, beginning from the larger diameter portion. The bridles are routed together off the bridle spool device over the pulley and then allowed to separate to go to the 3 points on the rover's top deck. The 3 tethers are each 25 feet long when fully deployed. The rotation rate or descent rate of the bridle assembly is maintained by the descent brake. Inside the housing of the brake are gearboxes and banks of mechanical resistors engineered to prevent the tether from spooling out too quickly or too slowly. The Confluence Pulley's main purpose is to maintain the merging point of the triple bridles to a single point. Maintaining a single point of the bridle confluence is key to the sky crane maneuver because it causes the force of the rover hanging under the descent stage to pull down at this central point. Bridles from the bridle device assembly go into the pulley through the horn. The bridles exit out of a hole under the pulley and then connect to the brackets on the rover deck. The 4th rope-like connection seen is an umbilical connection which provides power and communication between the rover and the descent stage until the last second. 3 seconds after rover separation, the mobility system activates and the rover's 6 wheels deploy, also functioning as landing gear. Sensors tell the descent vehicle that the rover has touched down, at which time special pyrotechnic or explosive cable cutters or guillotines then cut the rover's umbilical and bridles loose from the descent vehicle, which flies away out of the way. The cables must be cut so that the descent stage can fly safely away from the rover. If the ropes were not severed, The descent stage would just continue downward, crashing into the rover. The rover is now free on the ground.